I always tell my boys, Vinny and Angelo, the owners of Irandequera Dodge, that their January sales are like the Super Bowl. It's the biggest one of the year, the best of the best, and it's action-packed.
At the Irandequera Dodge Boys' huge January sale, $139 a month will score you a 2000 Neon. Catch a Stratus or Breeze loaded with options for just $89.95 or $159 a month, and that's with zero down. Buy a new 2000 Caravan and take 5 years to pay with no interest charges. No finance charges. In January, Irandequera Dodge has it all on sale.
You know, it's only once a year that the Men's Warehouse has a sale. But if it's a sale as big as this one, well, once is enough.
It takes a Men's Warehouse sale to beat a Men's Warehouse price.
You're gonna like the way you look. I guarantee it.
Stop at the Shop Stereo Shop.
We bought our son's car stereo here.
Our daughter's TV.
Your CD player.
And now your big screen.
Yes.
We've got something for everyone.
And Stereo Shop will beat any local price. That's right. TVs to VCRs, home audio to car audio, projections to camcorders, cellular to satellite. Stereo Shop will beat any local price.
At the Stereo Shop, customer satisfaction is everything.
Stop at the Shop, Stereo Shop.
News Source 13's Fast Track. Fast Track 13 is so powerful, it shows you when and where severe weather will strike. Its sophisticated projection even tells you what time the storm will hit. Rochester Radar, Fast Track, only on News Source 13.
From WOKR Rochester, this is 13 2000.
Good evening, everyone. Don Alhart along with Mike Catalana, Bill Peterson. We are down at the Hyatt. We have a lot of new friends. Yeah. Bill's been out in the crowd whipping everybody up.
I'm going to run for office when I'm done with this.
You've had a good time out there.
Oh, yeah. They're having a ball. And I'll tell you, I made all three of the bands so far tonight, and they're all fantastic. Really
right.
Good.
And any of the food tables, or you just happen to
I'm trying to skip over those and stick into the radishes, at least for a while.
Please, radishes. I saw him eating. He was all these people in the hot tub with him earlier.
They all came down to see what it's like. All the festivities taking place downtown. We're going to show you some of them right now. Jane Flasch is on the other side of this wall where the music is playing. And Jane, how's it going inside?
Don, it's getting harder and harder to hear you, as you might guess. That's because last time we were here, I was the only one on the dance floor. Now tonight, I'm the only one, it seems, who's not on the dance floor. This group is rocking out to Power Company here tonight, here at the Hyatt. No, dancing is not the only thing there is to do. There are three full floors of activities here. We caught up with people earlier in this evening who were getting digital pictures taken of this event, pictures that they will be able to purchase frames for and take home with them. We also caught up with some people downstairs who were part of a gambling saloon, and the stakes here are pretty high, we are told. The blue chips that you see at the table there are $500 chips. The red chips are $1,000 chips. I just happen to have one of those chips with me. By the way, Don, I didn't win this. They're just giving these things out. So if you want $1,000, I got it for you.
Okay. Everyone is certainly enjoying things in there. I mean, you can sense the atmosphere tonight. Jane, good to see you. Dance a little bit if you want. We'll get back to you in a few minutes. Another party is underway that we've been checking in throughout the night. That is out in Pittsburgh, St. John Fisher College. Doug still has, he got a new hat every time we come out there.
Hey, they're free.
He's a party animal. Hey, we're here with 2,000 very close friends. I think they're some of the youngest revelers on this New Year's. Say hi, everybody.
Hi, everybody. Wow. And that's what this party is all about tonight. It's about celebrating with the young and old.
At 11 weeks old, Connor Hester is among the youngest partiers, with a very good chance of being around to ring in the year 2100. Hester Plain's first New Year's party was in 1905. She was honored tonight as a lifelong resident of Pittsford and promises to celebrate past midnight.
I want to sit up and hold a dollar bill in my hand so I'll have some money next year.
Just in case something happens.
That's right.
As a little girl, Esther could not have imagined this, digital cameras and Kodak software to make memories. What will these children remember about dancing the night away as the 1900s faded to black? This celebration was just right for about 2,000 people who wanted to be out tonight, but not away from family and friends.
And now you're looking at the crowd live in Pittsburgh. It's a sold-out event. And I think the one thing that all of the kids told us here tonight is that the new millennium was a chance for a fresh start. And I thought that was rather refreshing to hear from these children, appreciating that we're starting anew tonight. And we're having a lot of fun. Indoor fireworks at midnight.
Right.
We've got confetti and a good party, a very good crowd. And
it really is.
There are going to be some tired kids tomorrow.
Jenny has asked them all to stay awake. The town supervisor asked them all to stay in bed tomorrow.
It's a directive.
Until 10 o'clock. So that's it from Pittsburgh for now. We'll be back later, Doug.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
The thought occurs to me that behind them they have young people who are not drinking because no alcohol is being served.
Right.
We have older people where alcohol is being served, and it's all the same. Nobody changes. I'm not sure. This is the group at the Hyatt Regency, and everyone is certainly enjoying it. We have 56 minutes until we welcome in this new year. A lot of people are working on this New Year's Eve, not only the people here at the Hyatt, but people all around this community. Among those who have been working very hard, the Rochester Police Department. I know I ran into Chief Duffy a little bit earlier this week. He was on vacation, but coming back to work tonight because it's a very important night. Peter Robbins tells us more about the men and women in blue who are working tonight.
Rochester police are ready for New Year's Eve. They're hoping it's going to be quiet downtown, but they are expecting a big crowd. They expect thousands of people to turn out. It's a pretty nice night, so they do think that a lot of folks will come downtown to watch the fireworks.
490 East, Contreras, Weeder.
Roll call for the Rochester police was around 7 o'clock this evening for those in the downtown section. They'll be stationed throughout downtown to handle the crowd, to also handle all of the street closings that people will be dealing with as they travel into downtown to watch the fireworks or attend some other festivities.
We're focusing our attention on downtown area. We have a large fireworks shoot at midnight. We have over 30 officers assigned. The officers are there to make sure that you cross safely and that you have a good, safe time.
In addition to their presence downtown, police say they will also have extra patrols out on the highways to look for DUI offenders on New Year's Eve and into New Year's Day morning. Reporting from downtown Rochester, Peter Robbins, News Source 13.
Thank you, Peter. And we point out as well, not only the city police department, I know I was looking at some other facts and figures from the state police. They have everyone across the state working tonight. So if you are venturing out tonight, please be very, very careful on the roads. And as always, do not drink and drive. Among the other people who are working on this New Year's Eve, the Office of Emergency Preparedness here in Rochester and Monroe County. Christine Rodgers has been with them throughout the day as they have looked at the clock, watched other communities, and seeing if Y2K is going to have any impact here. Has it, Christine?
Well, let me tell you, Don, a little different atmosphere here than what you're experiencing, certainly at the Hyatt, and let me assure you, no one is complaining. It's relatively quiet here, although the agencies, some 25 represented here, have been in place since 7 o'clock, just in case. Some of those agencies, of course, the Red Cross, Rochester Gas and Electric, State Police, everybody on hand, just in case. The computers are booted up, the radios are charged, but just to give you an idea that it's been relatively quiet, we've actually seen people reading books here and playing cards on their computer. That's not a bad thing, it's just that there really isn't anything for folks to do yet. Joining me is Muffy Meisenzahl, who's the lady in charge here tonight. Can you give folks at home a sense of what's going on here tonight?
It's very quiet here tonight, Christine, and that's indicative that there are no problems in the community, which is very good news for us. And that's why you see all the smiles and kind of a laid-back approach here right now.
This is somewhat unusual, though, isn't it? I mean, you're used to kind of scrambling everybody together for some snow emergency like we saw in March.
Yes. When we're here working in emergency, this is a very busy and very loud place. Phones are ringing, people are speaking on radios, and at the same time talking on telephones, and it's a very busy place. So this is unlike what we usually have when we're all gathered here.
But this isn't unusual either in the sense that many of these operations are going on across the state.
Oh, absolutely. Almost every county in this state and across the nation at the local level, emergency operations centers are activated in preparation and readiness for the rollover time period. And many of them are going to be staffed for a couple days out.
Muffy Meisenzahl, thank you very much. So relatively quiet here, Don. No music like you're experiencing there, but they expect a toast in the new year here without any problems.
Okay, and as they approach the midnight hour, they'll be watching a little more closely, but it initially doesn't look as though there's any concerns.
You know what, Don? People have been preparing for this for so long that there really is a comfort level here that they think things will go along just fine.
Okay. From Christine Rodgers, we go back to News Source 13 in the studio. Mary McCombs with some other news of this New Year's Eve. Mary.
Okay, thanks, Don. Well, in less than an hour, the new year begins, and many people spent much of this week getting Y2K ready. Grocery stores in our area are reporting increased sales in recent days. The hot item remains bottled water.
This week, we are selling five times the volume of water that we normally sell. But water is really the big item. Other than that, we're selling batteries, about 35% more than normal, and flashlights.
And canned goods like soup and baby food also selling just a bit above normal. Next week, it will be business as usual for Monroe County's executive. It's another 4 years in office for Jack Doyle, who was sworn in this morning at the county office building. Doyle pledging to make the community a better place to live.
Well, I think they expect leadership. I think they expect to see people working together. And I also think that they expect our economy to grow stronger so that they don't have concerns about their jobs, about the jobs of their children.
And several local dignitaries on hand for today's inauguration at the county office building. Well, on this last day of the century, the local African-American community is celebrating Kwanzaa. An event at Midtown Mall today wrapped up a week-long celebration of their roots. During the seven-day celebration, African-Americans also look at ways to improve their lives and communities. Today's gathering also included a spiritual message.
Kwanzaa is an annual celebration of just uniqueness among African Americans. A lot of people think that it replaces Christmas or the New Year, but it isn't. It's just another expression of being an African American.
And during the seven-day celebration, African Americans look at ways to improve their lives and communities. And that's the news of the day here in the studio, and things have been relatively quiet, Don. We've been receiving faxes from Rochester Gas and Electric. They tell us everything's operating smoothly. However, we have a Y2K glitch to report in the newsroom. The computers where we normally write our scripts on the rundowns, Don, they now say year 1900 before television was even around.
Here we are all night worried about everybody else's Y2K problems. We got to look in our own backyard,
yep, I guess. Just a little problem back here, but we'll get through it.
All right. Mary McCombs back in our studio tonight. Thank you for bringing us a news update. One of the items we always talk about on New Year's Day, the first baby born. We always scour the hospitals. Who's going to claim to have the first baby? In this case, the first baby born in the year 2000 takes on even more added significance, if you will. And Liz Bonis is standing by now to tell us about the preparations as we await the arrival.
I'm here with Chloe and Sydney Sarkis, who missed being Millennium twins by simply one day. Now, every year, the hospitals all have sort of a competition to see who's going to have a New Year's baby. And this year, with the Millennium, the countdown is really on.
I don't know, that's what I'm feeling, but it doesn't hurt.
Especially for Rebecca Pacalny. Already in labor, she has a few friends giving her some last-minute advice.
My whole family, they're all telling me to wait.
Her delivery team is by her side, just hoping to share a part of a Millennium miracle.
There's just nothing more exciting than that for them, and the fact that we can participate, that they can allow us to come in and be part of that celebration, I think is the real reward.
They have quite a few other moms already in labor here too.
We're waiting for the first baby of the new year.
But most moms, like Rebecca, are not wishing for the first baby of the new millennium. They're just wishing for a baby.
Now, just after midnight, all of the hospitals will be calling each other to find out who has the first millennium baby, and we'll be here to let you know who wins the competition. From Strong Memorial Hospital, I'm Liz Bonis for News Source 13 2000.
I'm just thinking as I watch that, if I were a woman in labor and somebody says, wait, you can be the first to hear. I don't think so.
Probably not.
We're going to take a break. We'll be back with more live from downtown Rochester as the party continues for 13 2000.
Thank you. We're going to slow it down.
People call it smart, thrilling, the place for values. Toyotathon 2000, the blockbuster event filled with great Toyota values. Your ride to the new millennium is here. Are you ready to go? Just $179 a month leases a well-equipped Corolla VE. $179 a month, and you're driving the most trusted car in the world. Toyotathon 2000. Now playing at your Toyota dealer. Rated GV for great values.
Max Pies Carpet's biggest sale day of the year is finally here.
You won't believe your eyes. It's a great surprise. It's a sale that comes just once a year.
New Year's Day, 11 to 6, Max Pies brings you top-of-the-line carpet as low as $11.99 a yard installed. Laminate flooring, just $4.99 installed in an 8x10 room. A 9x12 room installed with Armstrong vinyl, $1.99. Plus, no payments, no interest for 12 months. New Year's Day, 11 to 6, it's Max Pies New Year's sale.
With a sale like this, you just can't miss.
The best actors, the best plays, the best stage around. Join us and make our season complete. For information, call 232-JIVA.
Is Chandler desperate for a date?
He is cute. He's funny.
He's a he?
Yeah.
Or does he just look that way?
Is it my hair?
Yeah, you have homosexual hair.
And has Ross's Nana passed away? Or does she just look that way? Next, Friends.
Friends, Monday at 7, only on 13.
I always tell my boys, Vinny and Angelo, the owners of Iran de Quaridad, that their January sales are like the Super Bowl. It's the biggest one of the year, the best of the best, and it's action-packed.
At the Iran de Quaridad boys' huge January sale, $139 a month will score you a 2000 Neon. Catch a Stratus or Breeze loaded with options for just $89.95 or $159 a month, and that's with zero down. Buy a new 2000 Caravan and take 5 years to pay with no interest charges, no finance charges. In January, Iran de Quaridad has it all on sale.
How does one purchase an Oriental rug? Begin with the right rug dealer. At Thomas R. Paddock Oriental Rug Exchange, we have the knowledge, we have the selection, and we'll take the time to make sure you're comfortable with your rugs. And since we have only the finest quality rugs available, every choice is a good one. In fact, anything you purchase from us can be brought back and traded for what you paid, at any time, for any reason. That's why people come to us, Thomas R. Paddock Oriental Rug Exchange.
And we are back to the Hyatt Hotel. A little bit earlier this evening, we all watched as Rochester's own Margaret DeFrancesco introduced Yolanda Vega for the Millennium Millions, and the numbers on your screen, 8, 23, 38, 39, 46, and the special Millennium number of 14. A lot of numbers to talk about on this day as well. Stocks closing out today with an all-time high day in 1999. The Dow Jones Industrials up 44 points, 11,497 and 12 cents in change. So a lot of numbers to talk about. We want to talk about some numbers as far as the weather's concerned.
It is going to be a decent night for what's left of tonight, and certainly a nice day during the day tomorrow. Tonight, temperatures in the 20s, but we will warm up overnight. Look for partly cloudy skies. And then for Saturday, a mixture of sunshine and clouds and a spring-like 44 degrees for a high temperature, relatively gusty southwest winds. But certainly the weather has cooperated as we head into the new year.
And if people are traveling after this New Year's holiday, it looks like we'll have pretty clear travel.
Yeah, I think so. Right up through Monday, we're going to be in good shape.
All right. Sports as well on the... You and I pose for pictures. He's kissing people.
Yeah, I know.
I don't know what's, you know... They're all after him tonight.
I guess.
We want to see what's going on in the world of sports tonight, too, Mike Detlef.
Well, you know, the 90s are coming to an end, too, Don. All of our local teams are off this evening, but it has been quite a decade. We look back at the first five items from our top 10 list of all-time sports moments. Here's number five through number one, the Rhinos championship in 98. When they beat Minnesota to win it all, they did that at Frontier Field. In our list, number four, you remember this one, that comeback for the Bills in 1993 in the wild card game that got them to yet another Super Bowl. The Emirates won a championship in this decade. It happened in 1996 when they won the Calder Cup. There's Coach John Tortorella and company celebrating when they beat Portland. Number two, we go back to the Bills. Actually, it's all four Super Bowls together. And the first one happened in 1991. They lost that one with the old wide right kick of Scott Norwood. But the number one moment for Rochester sports fans, the Ryder Cup, 1995, here in Rochester, the United States, losing to the Europeans, our top sports moment of the 90s. Don?
All right, we'll have more at midnight and be back with a full wrap-up at 1 a.m. on this new day. We'll see you a bit later.
They have done.